The section 3 of chapter 3, Lattice Vibration, is one-dimensional quantum mechanical harmonic oscillator. First, let me explain why I treat this topic in this section. The lattice vibration is the collection of oscillating atoms. Therefore, the physical law that oscillating microscopic particles follow should be understood. The motions in microscopic scales are governed by quantum physics. Therefore, I will introduce some quantum physics in this chapter, in this section. We will argue a given state of a collection of the oscillating atoms. Such a motion is governed by the time-independent Schrödinger equation. The time-independent Schrödinger equation for one particle with mass m and energy e in one-dimensional space is minus h bar squared divided by 2m times the second derivative of a function psi with respect to the point x, position x, plus v, function vx times the function psi is equal to the energy E times the function psi. The Planck constant, which is 6.626 blah 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 times 10 to minus 35 joule second, is usually expressed by h, and h bar here is the reduced Planck constant, which is Planck constant h divided by 2 pi. The value is 1.054 blah 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 times 10 to minus 34 joule second. The function psi is referred to as the wave function, which is expressing the probability finding the particle at the position x. Vx is the potential energy that is operated to the particle at the position x. The wave function contains all information about the motion of the particle. Here, let us consider the harmonic oscillation. Harmonic oscillation is such that a particle with a restoring force proportional to its displacement. The restoring force is therefore expressed as minus kx. X is the position from the equilibrium position, namely the displacement, and k is the force constant, equation 3.4.2. The force can be related to the potential energy as F equals minus dV over dx, equation 3.4.3. By integrating equation 3.4.3 with the equation 3.4.2, we have the potential energy for the harmonic oscillation of V equal 1 over 2 times kx squared. Thus, the potential energy of the harmonic oscillation is parabolic. The Schrödinger equation for the particle in the parabolic potential is minus h bar squared divided by 2m times the second derivative of the wave function psi with respect to x plus 1 over 2 k, the force constant, times the displacement x squared times the wave function psi is equal to the energy E times the wave function psi, equation 3.4.5. In the classical mechanics, the equation of spring is F equal minus kx, and The equation motion is F equal m, the mass of the particle times the second derivative of position x with respect to time t. Therefore, the equation is m times the second derivative of the displacement x with respect to time t is minus kx. As well known, the solution for this equation 3.4.6 is x equal a times cosine omega t plus theta. Theta is the phase and omega a is the amplitude and omega is the angular frequency, which is equal to square root of the force constant divided by the mass m. Equation 3.4.7. The parameter of the force constant k is replaced by k equal m omega squared. From this relation, equation 3.4.8, therefore, the potential energy is written as Vx is equal to m omega squared x squared divided by 2, equation 3.4.9. Therefore, using this expression, the Schrödinger equation can be written as minus h bar squared divided by 2m times the second derivative of the wave function psi with respect to the displacement x square x plus the mass m times the angular frequency omega squared divided by 2 times the displacement x squared times the wave function psi is equal to the energy E times the wave function psi. Equation 3.4.5'. Unfortunately, the equation 3.4.9 is difficult to solve. Therefore, we will simplify and approximate this equation to make it easier to solve. First, we modified this equation as minus h bar squared over 2m times second derivative of psi with respect to x is equal to e minus 1 over 2m omega squared x squared times psi, equation 3.4.10. Then we use the variable psi and epsilon to replace the variable x and e as x equal square root of h bar over m omega times psi, equation 3.4.11, and e equal h bar omega over 2 times epsilon, equation 3.4.12. And we use function phi with a variable psi instead of a psi function psi with a variable x, then equation becomes the second derivative of phi with respect to x is plus epsilon minus psi squared times phi is equal to zero, equation 3.4.13. Unfortunately, this equation is still difficult to solve. Then let us assume the solution of equation 3.4.13 is phi equal h times exponential function minus psi squared over 2, equation 3.4.14. Then we put this solution into this equation. So the first term, the second derivative of phi with respect to xi is equal to second derivative with respect to xi of h times exponential function of minus xi squared over 2. Then we have a first derivative with respect to xi of first derivative of h with respect to xi times exponential function minus xi squared over 2 minus h times first derivative of with respect to xi of exponential function minus xi squared over 2. Then we calculate differentiation, and we obtained second derivative of h with respect to xi minus 2 times xi times the first derivative of h with respect to xi plus xi squared minus 1 times h times exponential function minus xi squared over 2. Then we put this term into this equation. Then we have this is the first term and the second term. This term is epsilon minus xi squared times h times exponential function of minus xi squared over 2 is equal to 0. Then we have a exponential function in both time. Then this equation becomes this formula, equation 3.4.16. This xi squared and this square minus xi squared are cancelled. Then we remove the factor exponential of minus xi squared divided by 2 from the equation 3.4.16. We have the second derivative with respect to xi minus 2 times xi times first derivative with respect to xi plus epsilon minus 1 applying to the function h equals 0, equation 3.4.17. We assume that h can be expanded by an algebra series. H xi is equal to summation of ak times xi, the kth power of xi from k equals 0 to infinity. Equation 3.4.18. Then we put this formula into equation 3.4.17. Then we have the k times k minus 1 times ak times k minus 2 power of xi from k equal 2 to infinite because of the second derivative of h minus 2 times xi times the summation of k times ak times k minus 1 power of xi from k1 to infinite because of the first derivative of function h plus epsilon minus 1 of the summation of ak times kth power of xi from k equals 0 to infinite, which is 0. Then we add 0 times a0 times 0th power of xi, which can be considered as the first term of this algebra series. Therefore, this one becomes 2 times k times ak times xi, kth power of xi from k0 from to infinite. And This algebra series can be considered k plus 2 times k plus 1 times ak plus 2 times kth power over xi from k0 to infinite. Therefore, this formula can be simplified as k plus summation of k plus 1 plus k plus 2, k plus 1 times k plus 2 times a sub k2 minus 2k minus epsilon plus 1 times a sub k times kth power of psi from k equals 0 to infinite, which is equal to 0. Equation 3.4.19. In order to make this summation always 0, the inside of the square bracket must be 0 by satisfying this recurrence. The a sub k plus 2 is equal to 2k minus epsilon plus 1 divided by k1 times k2 times a sub k. Using this form conditions, we have the function of h, which is sum of ak times a sub k times kth power of psi from k equals 0 to infinite as follows: a0 plus a1 psi and a sub 2 times second power of psi, but a sub 2 is expressed using epsilon minus 1 divided by 1 times 2 times a0. Therefore, it becomes this term, and fourth term is a4 times a3 times psi cubed, but a3 can be expressed a sub 1 times epsilon minus 1 divided by 2 times 3 as follows. Therefore, the function h is something like this. Equation 3.4.21. The solution, the formula 3.4.21 is an infinite series. Therefore, without special conditions, this series diverges when the xi is large. Therefore, we need a condition for the convergence of the formula 3.4.21 with at any xi. If epsilon is equal to 2n minus 1, n equals, of course, the integer. Equation 3.4.25. Even a sub n is non-zero, the higher term becomes 0, and the series become finite. As a n plus 2 is equal to minus epsilon minus 2n plus 1 divided by n plus 1 plus times n plus 2 times a sub n, and if epsilon equal n minus 2n minus 1, then this numerator becomes 0. Therefore, an plus 1 plus 7 becomes 0. Therefore, this is a necessary condition or a sufficient condition so that the h becomes has a finite value when the epsilon xi have a large values. Then forms of H. There are many form H psi according to the conditions epsilon is equal to 2n minus 1. And each h function h is expressed using h sub n. And this h sub n is referred to as Hermite polynomials. H0 is constant a0. H sub 1 is equal to a1 psi. And h sub 2 is a0 1 minus 4 over 1 over 2 h psi squared. H3 is a1 minus 4 over 2.2 times 3 psi cubed, blah blah blah. Equation 3.4.27. Then, from these results, wave function has psi have this formula. Psi x is equal to c times Hermite polynomial of square root of m omega divided by h bar x times exponential function of minus m omega divided by 2h bar x squared, equation 3.4.21. And because epsilon energy is h bar omega over 2 times epsilon, and epsilon is equal to 2 times integer n plus 1, the allowed energy E is equal to h bar omega divided by 2 times 2n plus 1 is equal to h bar omega times n plus 1 over 2, equation 3.4.30. Then, what we can understand from this mathematical derivation is the permitted energy level is discrete, energy is expressed EV, E nu, which is equal to H bar omega divided by 2 epsilon nu, which is equal to H bar omega divided by 2 times nu times 1 over 2. Nu equals 0, 1, 2, 3, blah, 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 which is referred to as quantum number. And omega is k over m squared. So omega increases with increasing the force constant k and decreasing the mass of the particle m. And even nu equals 0, the energy is not 0. E0 is 1 over 2 h bar omega. So this figure shows the energy of the harmonic oscillators. The lowest is 1 over 2 h bar omega, which is non-zero, and second one is 3 over 2 h bar omega, and the third is 5 over 2 h bar omega for the quantum number of 0 and 1 and 2. The separation between adjacent levels are always constant, omega bar, epsilon energy, nu plus nu sub e nu sub 1 plus e nu plus 1 minus e nu is equal to h bar omega. So these are separations always the same for all nu. So this is some kind, so referred to as ladder spacing. This is the end of section 3 of chapter 3, Lattice Vibration, One-Dimensional Quantum Mechanical Harmonic Oscillator.